You know, they say that dreams are real only as long as they last. Couldn't say the same thing about life. See, there's a lot of us that are out there that are mapping that mind-body relationship of dreams. We're called the Oneironites. We're the explorers of the dream world. Really, it's just about the two opposing states of consciousness, which don't really oppose at all. See, in the waking world, the neural system inhibits the activation of the vividness of memories. And this makes evolutionary sense. See, it'd be maladaptive for the perceptual image of a predator to be mistaken for the memory of one, and vice versa. If the memory of a predator conjured up a perceptual image, we'd be running off to the bathroom every time we had a scary thought. So you have these serotonic neurons that inhibit hallucinations, that they themselves are inhibited during REM sleep. See, this allows dreams to appear real while preventing competition from other perceptual processes. This is why dreams are mistaken for reality. To the functional system of neural activity that creates our world, there is no difference between dreaming, perception, and action, and actually the waking perception and action.
job that you hated, worked really hard at. Long, hard day of work, finally you get to go home, get in bed, close your eyes, and immediately you wake up and realize that the whole day at work had been a dream. It's bad enough that you sell your waking life for minimum wage, but now they get your dreams for free.